Good morning, students. Welcome back in our science online class. Today we are going to discuss about the types of garbage. Okay, so there are two types of garbage, students. First one is biodegradable, that is called useful components, and second one is non-biodegradable, that is called non-useful components. So students, what is mean by actually biodegradable? What is the meaning of this biodegradable? Bio means living. Okay students, so living organism decompose some materials. Which material especially? Useful material. So living organisms, especially the microorganisms. So microorganisms decompose some materials and convert into the harmless substances that we can reuse again. So what is the definition of a biodegradable, students? The part of garbage. See, what is the definition of biodegradable? The part of the garbage that can be decomposed. The part of the garbage that can be decomposed in nature to form harmless substance. The part of garbage which can decompose in the nature and convert into the harmless substances is called biodegradable. Or you can make one more definition. Biodegradable, the part of the garbage which can decomposed by an organism and convert into the useful components or substance, that is called biodegradable substance. Now biodegradable is also called the useful components of the substances. Now which are the, especially the pins of fruits, parts of vegetables, paper, pieces of papers, you can write, okay. Then next thing, water. Then stalks of plants, dry leaves. All these components are the biodegradable components. It means that these components can be decomposed. Decompose means what, students? Decompose means the microorganism can break down them into the smaller pieces. The microorganism which can convert these substances into the useful component, that is called the humus. That is called the organic matter. Okay? So biodegradable, the type of waste typically originating from the plants, animals, which can be decomposed by other living organisms by the water. So living organisms, especially the microorganisms, bacteria. Okay? The microorganisms convert this breakdown these all the components, especially dry leaves, pills of fruits, waste vegetables, left to food. Okay, so that things convert into the useful substances, harmless substances, that is called the humus or organic matter. And that humus, organic matter, mix in the soil, or we can use as a manure. Manure means khat, and that manure is good for the growth of plants. Okay students, so this is the biodegradable. Now non-biodegradable means what? The part of the garbage which cannot be decomposed by living organism. The part of the garbage which cannot be decomposed by living organism, such garbage is called non-biodegradable, or we can called the non-biodegradable substances or the components. So in garbage there are some components which cannot be decomposed by living organism, especially microorganism, and that part remain as it is for a long time. Such part called as the non-biodegradable substances, and these non-biodegradable substances are harmful to the soil as well as for the organism also, living organism. So biodegradable means useful components, and non-biodegradable means non-useful components. For example, plastic, glass, you know, glass and plastic, these are the non-biodegradable components. Means microorganisms cannot eat or cannot convert these components like plastic, glass into the useful components, and that is why they are non-biodegradable. For better understanding, one thing you can do, do you know the plastic? If you put the plastic in soil, you can make the one pit and put some plastics, polythene bags in it and cover with the soil. And after 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months. So after 1 year or after 6 months, you go and again you remove the top layer of that soil where you put all the these polythenes, and just you observe. So what you are going to observe again, you will get there again same polythene. Means that polythene will not decompose, or that polythene cannot be decomposed by microorganism. That is called the non-biodegradable substances. Okay, students. So this is about the biodegradable and non-biodegradable substances. Now next part, treatment of useful components of garbage composting. So how to treatment? Now treatment means what? Now treatment means converting plant and animal waste, including the kitchen waste, into the manure is called composting. Now we are going to learn the one more interesting method of dealing with garbage. How to deal with that garbage? How to use that garbage to make the useful components? See, dealing with garbage is very easy. See here, whatever the biodegradable waste is there, biodegradable garbage is there, biodegradable substances are there. That biodegradable substances, especially the waste of plants and animals. So converting means we are converting, okay? Converting plants and animal waste, including kitchen waste. See, animal waste, plant waste, and including kitchen waste into manure. Manure means again fertilizer. Manure is called composting. So this is the one process. Okay? And this process name is composting. One more time I will repeat this definition for you. The converting of plants and animal waste, including kitchen waste, into manure is called composting. This process is called composting. Now see here. Here you can see the one picture is given. Can you see this picture clearly, students? I will little bit zoom this picture. Okay. Can you see this picture now, students? Okay. Now here you can see brown leaves or poor materials. So this material is from the plants. Plus green grass or food. Okay, this is the green grass. Now these two materials, when mixed together, are decomposed. So we will get what? Compost. That is the manure. Okay. Then again, one you can see the water again, microorganisms, and these microorganisms like bacteria, fungi, and microbes. Okay, and here. Now see how the compost happens. Actually, the composting method is what, students? So this is the one method which is used to make the manure at home. Have you observed sometime, especially if you go to the village, you can see the person who is having cow, buffaloes, you know, who is doing farming. So whatever the waste material is there of cow, buffaloes, ox, so that person, that is called the cow dung. So that person makes one pit like pit in front of his house, and he put all, every day, he put that garbage, like garbage means which can be converted into the manure. So for example, cow dung, okay, waste of cow, buffaloes, okay, sheep, bull, whatever are there. Second thing, then he, whatever the food items are there, like which can be biodegraded, like peels of fruits, then left food. So he put every day the this waste material into that pit. And after some year or after some month, so that all the material decomposed by the microorganisms and converted into the manure. And after 6 months or after 1 year, farmer collects all that manure and spread in his field. So this is the one type of good manure for the growth of plants. That is why the farmer especially don't throw the cow dung outside. Okay, they reuse again this cow dung. So this is the one method of composting. Okay, students, understood? Now next part is our why we have different dustbins. So this part will continue in our next video, students. Okay, so I hope you understood today biodegradable, non-biodegradable, and third one is about the composting. Okay, students, so you prepare these all the definitions at home. Okay, definition of biodegradable, definition of non-biodegradable, and definition of composting. Okay, students, I hope you understood today's part. We'll see or we'll meet in next video.